everyone. My name is Shoaib Chauhan, PhD scholar from Division of Vegetable Science, IRN Delhi. Today is my last class and second class of legume crops. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about the remained legume crops. And at last, I will also tell you about how to prepare for GRF and SRF exam in horticulture. So be there. And before starting the lecture, I want to tell you that in legume crop, the important thing which you have to remember is their botanical name, their progenitor, the legume crop having a unique chromosome number, and their origin. Along with that, any unique variety in legume crop or legume crop with respect to the day length requirement, their seed germination temperature and seed rate, and any unique substance like in the cluster bean, the galactomannan is there, or in faba bean, it is a only bean which is grown in winter season. Like that, you have to remember the things. And in between, I was saying that many people are leaving the meeting. My friends, I want to tell you that don't do that, because if you want to succeed in anything in your life, consistency and perseverance is more important. The person who stay till end, he only gets something. If you are living in between, it is not the good thing. Okay, and let's start the lecture. First off, we are going to discuss is a cluster bean, botanical name Cymopsis tetragonobus. Commonly it is known as gor. It is a Hindi word. Family is leguminosae. Chromosome number is 14. And origin is India and Africa. The cluster bean is a short day plant. Like this question you have to remember. And progenitor is Cymopsis senegalensis. And a cluster bean is a warm season crop, and it tolerant. The unique thing of cluster bean is that it tolerant drought and pH up to 7.5 to 8. It is grown for both tender pod and dry seed purpose, and it is also used as fodder and green manure crop. It is mainly is rainy season crop. It is self-pollinated in nature, and inflorescence is racemose. Flower color is white or pink, and the plant is having trifoliate leaf. Trifoliate leaf means on a single point three similar leaves are there. It is called as trifoliate. And Rajasthan is largest producer of cluster bean. And this question is asked in JRF. In cluster bean, which substance is present? It is a mucilaginous substance which is known as galactomannan. Please remember galactomannan. And a cluster bean seed contain galactomannan polysaccharide, which is also known as gor gum. Means this polysaccharide is known as gor gum. It has immense use in food and pharma industry. And young plant of cluster bean contain toxic substance, which is hydrocyanic acid or durin. In exam, they may ask which toxic substance is present in cluster bean. They may ask hydrocyanic. They will give hydrocyanic acid or durin in option. So you have to do accordingly. And therefore, we saw my friend that cluster bean plant is generally at younger stage not used as a fodder, because it has a toxic substance is there, but it is used as fodder after the flowering and pod stage, so that the toxic substance will not be there. Now varieties: Boma manjari, it is resistant to powdery mildew, bacterial blight, and leaf spot disease. Pusa mausami is for rainy season, and Pusa selection from local variety Jaipur of Rajasthan, and it is suitable for both the season. Pusa Naubahar, it is non branching type variety developed by through hybridization. Sharad Bahar is a branching hybrid variety. Cluster bean is a hardy and drought tolerant crop, and suitable for growing in summer and rainy season. The sowing time is February to March, and for early crop, and for main crop, its sowing is done in June July. And seed rate is important in legume crop. The cluster bean seed rate is 25 to 30 kg per hectare. Spacing is 45 by 10 to 15 cm. And inoculation with rhizobium in legume crops are important, because it help in fixation of the atmospheric nitrogen. And flowering in most of the legume crop, flowering in pod development is most critical stage for irrigation. Now harvesting and yield. Tender bean pods are started picking 45 days after sowing. And dry seeds are harvested for seed purpose. Also, the cluster bean is used. The dry seeds are harvested, and the last percentage of pods are filled with seed, and pod color change to yellow. The harvesting for seed purpose is done before the pod starts shattering. Shattering problem is there in cluster bean. And average tender pod yield in cluster bean is 3 to 4 tons per hectare. Now the next crop, legume crop is Indian or Dolly Kaurpi. Its botanical name is Labla purpureus. Please remember, in legume crop, the common name are important. Generally, it is asked in exam. Common name of Indian bean are Hyacinth bean, Dolly Chalk bean, Bonavist, Egyptian bean, Australian pea, Salad bean, Sem or Wall. Wall it is Marathi word and Sem it is in Hindi. Family is Leguminaceae and chromosome number is 22 or 24. Origin is India. And it is important that cluster bean is a short day plant. It is used for vegetable, green marine and pulse, also used for pulse also. There are two types of cultivar, pole type and bush type. The tender, the vegetable purpose Indian bean, botanical name is Labla purpureus typicus. Field type or pulse type Indian bean is Labla purpureus, Labla purpureus variety lignosus. It is a full season but drought tolerant crop. Indian bean has more nutritional value than French bean. It may ask in exam. Indian bean, we know that it is a self-pollinated crop. Flower color is white or purple. A trypsin inhibitor is mostly present in legume crop. It's in beans and pea. It is also important. It is a harmful substance. And bush type cultivar of Indian bean, which are photo-insensitive, tolerant to drought and heat, are Arka Jai and Arka Vijay. And Arka Vijay and Konkan Bhushan, these are dual purpose variety. But Arka Jai is only used for vegetable purpose. In exam, it may ask that Arka Vijay is used for vegetable purpose or for both purpose. So remember this, Arka Jai and Arka Vijay. Now, pole type cultivars are Pumsa Sem 2 and 3. It is having excellent organoleptic quality. Means it is having good quality in respect of taste, color, odor and feel. It is highly tolerant to viruses, anthracnose, aphid, jassid, pod borer and frost. Arka Adarsh, Arka Krishna, Arka Pradhan, Arka Vistar and Arka Bhavani. These are pole type cultivar and photo insensitive in nature. After that, Arka Swagat, it is suitable for round ear cultivation and it is developed by using pure line selection. Kashi Haritima, it is a moderate resistant to Dolichos, Yellow Mosaic Virus, Jassid, Aphid and Pod Borer. Arka Amog, it is suitable for Maharashtra cultivation. And other pole type varieties are Arka Somya, Arka Shambharan, Pusa Early Prolific, Dipali, Dasra, Rajni and Co-1 to Co-5. Now, semi-pole type cultivars are Kashi Sheetal, Kashi Kushal. As its name indicates, Sheetal means it is tolerant to low temperature and Kashi Kushal is tolerant to high temperature. Remember this. Bush type cultivar are Arka Jai and Arka Vijay. Arka Jai is a vegetable type cultivar having excellent qualities, the cooking quality. Arka Vijay is dual purpose variety. Mutant varieties are important in the ARF exam. It is asked that mutant variety of Indian bean is Co-10. Co-10 and Co-9. Co-10 is important because it is artificially developed. It is developed by using X-ray induced mutation. Dolichos bean is a cool season crop and tolerant to drought. Plant starts shooting in 2.5 to 3 months after sowing, and its fruit pod bear up to entire winter and early spring. Now photo insensitive varieties like Arka Jai, Arka Swagat and Arka Vijay are suitable for grown throughout the year. Now seeds of Indian bean are sown in June, July or July, August. Seed rate is important. In case of pole type, seed rate is 10 to 12 kg, and for bush type it is 25 to 30 kg per hectare. Pole type cultivar are supported using bamboo poles or trellis, and in mixed crop it is important the Indian beans plant are supported on sorghum and ragi plants. Harvesting and yield, a bush type cultivar it takes 2 months to harvest the crop, and pole type cultivar are ready for first picking in 3 months after sowing. The average yield is 8 to 12 ton per hectare in pole type and 4 to 6 ton per hectare in bush type. Now the next legume crop is Lima bean. Its botanical name is Phaseolus nanatus. The common name are important. Baby, it is known as baby potato, butter bean and double bean. Family Leguminaceae, chromosome number is 22. origin is important. It is a Guatemala. Lima bean is similar to French bean, but it is not commonly grown in India. It may ask in exam, and it is cross compatible with French bean because it's the genus is common, Faciola. Types of lima bean are means the cultivar in lima bean are pole type, semi pole, and bush type. Lima bean is often a cross pollinated crop. It is a unique character because most of the legumes are self pollinated in India. It is also used for wine preparation, and lima bean cannot tolerate the frost. Varieties in pole type: Florida butter, Challenger, King of Garden, Carolina butter, KKI1. Semi pole type are Hopi and Bimbo. In these minor vegetables, like in this lima bean, they may ask sometimes the unique varieties, the name, the varieties which are having unique name, like Hopi, the varieties of which crop, they may ask. But Challenger or King of Garden is a variety of, so remember, bush type, harder, Henderson bush, or 242, baby potato, and baby photo. Based on common name, you can remember the baby potato and baby photo. In case of climate, it required dry and cool climate, and it go well at the temperature in 15 to 20 degrees Celsius. At high temperature, the pollination, fertilization, and pod seeding are severely reduced. Now, seeded, for small seeded cultivar, seeded is 20 to 35 kg per hectare, and for large seeded variety, the seeded is 45 to 50 kg per hectare. Sowing is done in twice in a year, first in June, July, and second in summer, spring. Now, harvesting engine. The tender pods are ready for harvesting 85 to 90 days after sowing, and average pod yield is 5 to 10 tons per hectare. Now, next legume crop is broad bean. Botanical name is Vicia. Hello, any problem? Hello, students?
It's not visible to that slide.
Your slide? I think your voice is not also not clear.
Lima bean.
Okay.
Last slide.
You have good network or internet or not? You are facing some problem because your voice is also not clear. It is same for other students or not?
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir. He's asking about the last slide of lima bean.
Okay. Which point? Miss? Now it is visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You can take screenshot, no problem. Okay, the next crop is broad bean. And don't worry, we will share the recording of lectures, no problem. In broad bean, the botanical name is Vicia faba. Common name are important. Common name are faba bean, horse bean, and bakla bean. Family is leguminaceae, chromosome number is 12. It is important because only broad bean having lowest chromosome number among the legumes, which is 12. Origin is Central Asia, South America, and Europe. It is the only bean which is grown in winter crop, which is very important point. It is the only bean which is grown in winter. And this question is the pollen grain and pods of the broad bean is cause allergy to some people, which turn to serious illness. It is known as favism or homeolytic anemia. In IRA entrance 2019, if this question is asked, in which crop the favism is caused? The answer is broad bean. And broad bean cultivar are classified based on the seed color and pod size. And in case of white seeded cultivars, the seed are soft and less means they are less soft. In case of green seeded cultivar, the seed are soft and suitable for freezing. And broad bean, it is not fully self-pollinated crop, and a natural cross-pollination in broad bean is reported up to 20 to 40%. It may ask that which of the following legume crop is pollinated by insect. So in case of broad bean, sometimes there is pollination by insect also. Then, mainly it is a self-pollinated crop, but due to insect pollination, sometimes cross-pollination is also there. Now varieties. Varieties, long podded cultivar are Imperial White Long Pod, Imperial Green Long Pod, Masterpiece Green Long Pod, and Red Epicure. Based on these are unique name and very long name. So you can remember the name of varieties of broad bean. And small and important cultivar are Imperial White Winchester and Imperial Green Winchester. Means well, the cultivar are having name Imperial. Imperial in it. It is a variety of broad bean. Imperial or Winchester name is there, then it is a cultivar of broad bean. Pusa Audit and Pusa Sumit are Indian cultivar. You have to remember this may ask because these are Indian cultivar. Pusa Audit is a dual purpose variety suitable for packing and transport. It is important. Pusa Sumit having average pod yield 18 tons per acre. Climate, it is mainly grown at higher elevation. Please remember. And broad bean is a hardy plant. Only bean which is grown in winter season. It can tolerate temperature up to low as 4 degrees Celsius. Seed rate is 70 to 100 kg per hectare and sowing is done in July August. And in case of hills, sowing done in summer. Harvesting and yield, the tender green spots are ready for harvesting for ready for picking in 3 to 4 months after sowing. The average pod yield is 7 to 10 tons per hectare. Now the last legume crop we are going to discuss is winch bean. Botanical name is P. sopocarpus tetragonovus. The common names are important. Common name are boa bean, four angle bean. Why it is called as four angle bean? We know because based on its pod structure. Okay. And other name is vegetable of 20th century. And vegetable of 22nd century is anybody know?
Watermelon.
Very good. Very good. Okay. Other names are a princess pea, supermarket on stock. Okay, family is Leguminaceae, chromosome number is 18 or 22. The origin is Madagascar in Africa. It is a self-pointed crop, short day plant. Remember this, it is a short day plant. In a unique thing in winch bean is that in winch bean, all parts of plant are edible, including pod, leaves, tuberous root, flower, and seeds. Remember this. And varieties are, there are few varieties only, IHR selection 20, 60, 71 and WBG2. The tall spacing in tall cultivar are 70 to 100 by 25 to 50 centimeter. In case of dwarf cultivar, 60 by 25. Sowing is in June, July. And average pod yield is 15 to 25 tons per hectare. And disease and pest. Common disease and pest in legume crops are powdery mildew in case of disease, anthracnose, rust, green yellow mosaic virus, wilt, and pest are stem fly, serpentine leaf miner, pod borer, aphid, and thrips. And this much is for legume crop. Now, how to prepare for GRF and SRF exam in horticulture? First, prepare yourself mentally. The most important thing in doing in any work is you should have be mentally prepared. Before starting the preparation, you should know what you are doing. And I have saw the many students that they are preparing just because their friends are preparing or their senior told them to prepare because it is having good scope. You should your place should not be like that. Your decision to prepare for the exam is solely yours only. Listen to your inner voice before starting the preparation. If you ask yourself, it is good for me or what, or you want to do anything else in which you have more potential. So first prepare yourself because if you are not mentally not prepared, then you are not able to get the expected result. Then this is the moral things. After that, selection of books, planning and time management along with the dedication and hard work. Means I want to tell you that as I have in the start of lecture, I have told it, your dedication, consistency and perseverance are important because it is the most important thing. Without that, you can't get anything. After that, the planning and time management plays a key role in your success. In case of preparation, first you prepare your rough plan of a year or 6 months from the starting day to the month of exam. In planning, in management, in strategy, you have to decide which book you will read, how many times you have to revise the book, and whether you want to prepare notes or not, and what you will read at the last month, which is the most critical time of your preparation. And set your daily and monthly goals. Means I am telling that you have to decide, you have to set the target that which book you will complete in how many days and how many time in from what from when you will start your revision. You have to give specific time to particular book. If you are reading without any time deadline, then you will continually read one or two book for 2 to 3 months. It is not correct. Okay, and select the books which cover maximum 80% to 90% portion, because it is better to revise. If it is better to read the selected books and revise more time instead of reading more number of books available in the market. Okay, and your preparation should be exam oriented. It is a most important thing. Your preparation should be exam oriented. Which type of question is asked in exam? What is the pattern? You should know all the things, and mainly focus on the syllabus from which in every year the most maximum question is asked. Okay, now after reading some basic books like Handbook of Horticulture or Basic Horticulture, you have to read some objectives. You have to read the previous year questions. So we'll get the basic idea which type of question they are asking. If you are reading all books and you don't know what type of question they ask, then you will not read according to exam. So it is important after reading some basic book to read the some previous year questions. So you will get some basic idea and you will read accordingly. And mainly focus on theoretical book in your initial and middle month of preparation, because the objective book you have to read at the last only in the last 2 to 3 months and only for 2 to 3 hours after your dinner, when your mind is less attentive. Because for attend objective question, you don't need much efforts. Okay, now these are the list of books for GRF Horticulture. You can take screenshot, and I want to tell you that this much books are enough to top in exam. If you read these books with from your soul, you can easily get some good rank. So I have sequence likewise, and I want to tell you that if you have started reading horticulture book, you have to continue with horticulture only. When you have started the fruit science book, you have to continue with all fruit science book, because you can compare the content given in different book of same subject. Okay, and likewise in my case, during my time, I have fixed the target based on my reading ability, in which in how many days I can complete basic horticulture or handbook of horticulture. Likewise, you have to prepare your rough plan of 6 months or 1 year. In how many period you can complete one reading, and how many time is required for the revision. And for easy thing to complete your target is you can count the total pages of your book and how many days you have allotted to your particular book. You can divide the page number, so you can get the daily target of page number. So you can easily achieve your target. Okay. And one note is for that, always keep watch on your table. Don't use mobile while reading. Benefit of keeping watch on your table is that after 2 to 3 hours, you have to analyze yourself that from you are reading from 2 to 3 hours, what you have read, whether what you have read is effective or not, or you want to improve or not, like that. And one tip is, which is very important, during last month of our preparation, we need to only focus on our notes or only one or two important books which has maximum portion of your syllabus. Then so for that, if you are willing to prepare notes in case of that, means you can use Gloucester Horticulture or Instant Horticulture to, when you are reading other books, you can additional point which are not given in Gloucester or Instant Horticulture. These books, if you have time, you can read, no problem. These are also good books. And for important thing is for spices and medicinal aromatic plant, the portion given in Gloucester of Horticulture and Handbook of Horticulture are enough. Don't refer other things, because many people ask that, sir, what we have to read for spices or medicinal aromatic plant. So no need to worry, you cover this, the portion given in Gloucester and Handbook of Horticulture, that much is enough. And along with this, so in present time, they are asking the question in related to the current news, like the current news, like questions like in my GRF, they have asked that which day is celebrated as World Soil Day, or which day is celebrated as which year is celebrated as International Horticulture Year. Likewise, you have to refer the current news. The books are available in market of current agriculture. You can refer that. And in every year, there are 2 to 3 questions are from varieties. every year they ask at least two name of new varieties, two to three new varieties. For that you have to visit the website of IARI, IHR and IAVR official website. Okay, now the more important thing is mock test is very important, because if you are giving mock test, it will improve your confidence, it reduce your mistakes, and you will feel confident, because exam day is very important. If you have prepared your whole year with full dedication, if you are unable to perform on exam day, then it is your preparation is useless. Then therefore mock test is important, because it reduce your mistakes and improve your confidence. You will perform well, and paper exam pattern are here. You know, I think I will in short I will explain. The marks in GRF and SRF exam are the same. Question number of questions are also same. But in case of SRF, part there are three parts. Parts. Part one is 20 question of general agriculture and reasoning. Part two is of horticulture, and part three is of your main subject. And as I have told you that you have to prepare. You have to set your strategy for exam day. You have to set your strategy for exam day, like how many questions you have to attempt. And before that, I want to tell you that when you are attending the exam, first do the questions which you 100% in the answer of that question, you know 100% that you are sure it is right. First, in first read, do that question only. Don't waste on the question in which you are confused. In second reading, you have to do the questions in which you have miss you are confused between two options. Go for that question. Okay, and I want to tell you that don't miss. Try to do maximum in questions in which you are confused between two options, because in your exam for one wrong question the deduction is only 1 mark, but for right questions for one right question it is 4 mark. 4 times mark is there. So go for the maximum questions in which you are confused. You have read it something, but you are confused somewhat. So go for that question and note it down correctly, that don't try to attend the questions in which you don't know anything, because in that question the probability is more to getting the answer is wrong. So don't try to attend the questions in which you have more probability, means in which you don't know anything. Okay, don't try to do this. Only attend in which you have some confusion. And after reading, you will get some basic knowledge about the question paper. It is hard, easy, or it is easy, moderate hard. Based on you have to set your target initially. How many questions you will attend? Okay. And it is also depend on your studies. If your studies are well, then your even hard question paper will seem easy to you. If your preparation is not good, then your even easy question paper seem difficult to you. So remember, study is important. And at last, these are all planning preparation, and these are all strategy. Your planning how to read and which books you have to prepare. But the most important thing which decide your success is your dedication, your hard work, consistency, and confident on yourself. But the confidence is come from your hard work. If you are putting maximum effort, definitely your confidence will increase. So keep remember this, your dedication, consistency, and perseverance will be there. And it is that there is no need to come IRA or to inspire from IRA student. IRA should be in your heart and mind. As Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam says, that dream is not what you see in sleep. The dream is that not allow you to sleep. And these are the books for vegetable SRF, for vegetable part you can take screenshot. And this much is from my side for this lecture series. And I thank you all, and I thank Shridhar sir for giving me the opportunity to take these lectures. And I wish you a very good luck, and I wish you a very bright future. Thank you very much. And if you have any queries regarding the lecture and exam, you can ask.
Is broadband also often cross-pollinated or self?
No, it is self-pollinated.
Sir, but cross-pollination also?
It is there, but in some cases, when insect is there. Generally, it is self-pollinated. You remember only self-pollinated top. Broadband is self-pollinated top, but in some cases, insect pollination is there. only lima bean is often cross pollinated crop. Rest are self pollinated.
Hello, sir.
Yes, yes.
Sir, I want to ask a question about the exam, SIF exam.
Yes, yes.
Sir, will there be statement type questions also in SIF?
Yes, yes. They are asking now. It is general. They are asking statement type questions. They are giving one or two statements, and they are asking whether the statement are true or false. Whether the one statement is related to second or not, like that. Your okay, concept sir, will be clear for that.
Okay, sir.
Yes.
Sir, in JRF point of view, we want to study all varieties in the crop or in a specific varieties which have a specific characters. That type we want to study or all varieties, sir.
No, only the varieties are from IRI, IIVR or IHR, and the varieties which are having unique traits only. That only they will ask. They will not ask because in vegetables there are. In the varieties in so many number, so much in number, you can't remember that. Okay,
sir.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, where we can get the statistical data about horticulture crops?
You can go on website of National Horticulture Board, or there is one PDF from the Ministry of Farmer Welfare, I think. One PDF is there, you can go there. National Horticulture Board or Ministry of Agriculture.
Yeah, you refer the National Horticulture Board data, so that definitely they will ask from that data itself.
How many JRF seeds for horticultures are there at present?
70 seeds are there. But you have to check the new seed allotment also, so that you will find some idea about how many seeds are there. Nearly 70 seeds are there. Okay, but if you want to get IRI, if you are general rate, definitely you have to come in fifth rank itself. Okay, if you are having some category, you have to be in within rank 15. Okay,
for IRI, I want to tell you that fifth rank, under fifth rank for your favorite subject.
Yes.
Which subject you want to pursue your PG, for that your rank should be below or up to 5, or if you want to do PG in, up to PhD also, then up to 20, if your rank is up to 20 or 16 also, will get IRA, but not in your favorite subject. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And so what is the amount of scholarship in GRF or SRF?
If you get JRF, you will get 12,500 per month. If you get SRF, you will get 31,000 per month. But in PhD third year, you will get 35,000 per month. Okay.
And in case of IRA, if you got IRA and if you didn't got JRF or SRF, you will get IRA fellowship. IRA fellowship for PG is 7,500, but for PhD it is 31,000.
Sir, you have told about ORF 138. What does it ORF?
Open reading frame. Actually, in depth, if you see one gene, always one gene start from one starting codon, ends with stop codon, right? I think you have heard about starting codon and stop codon. Okay. When you see one gene from starting codon to stop codon, it will be called as open reading frame. Okay, whenever open reading frame is there, there will be one stop codon and there will be one start codon. Okay, in coal crops, ORF 138, that is one gene that is called as 138. That's why open reading frame 130 is responsible for Ogura meal sterility in coal crops as well as in radish. Okay. Just Google through open reading frame, you will find the same answer. If you want to know more, you can Google it.
Okay, sir. What is dry matter content?
Dry matter content is nothing but like if you take one crop, there will be dry matter content. Okay, if you see one crop, there will be different components like moisture content and different vitamin content, protein content, carbohydrate content. Likewise, there is dry matter also. That is, I told about 6 to 9% turnip. Just to remember that one. Okay, it is one of the component in roots. Okay, that is enough.
Okay, sir. Is there any maturity indices for brinjal?
What?
Is maturity indices for brinjal?
Maturity indices, normally we see size as a maturity index. Okay, when you obtain the optimum size of a brinjal, you will harvest. Okay, there is no specific maturity index. We'll see one size as well as complete color development. We will take these two factors as maturity indices. Normally we will take size as maturity indices. Okay,
okay, sir. Thank you.
Brinjal is climatic or non-climatic, sir?
Brinjal is non-climatic. Okay, tomato is climatic, whereas brinjal is non-climatic.
Sir, there's a question in citrus. Can I ask question regarding citrus, sir?
Actually, yeah,
miss, we can ask, but we don't miss. It's our JRF is in 2017. Now it is 2021. So from that, we have not read about fruits.
Actually, 2017, we left reading the other subject except vegetable science.
You can ask if you are able to answer, then
We will answer.
So, jaise ki citrus is a non-climatic fruit, sir, but means we harvest it after it gets mature. So then, why degreening is done in citrus? Means we will harvest it after it develop color, na? Degreening is a process generally done in citrus, sir.
Shubh, do you have any idea?
I think citrus is non-climatic, I think.
Okay, Impa, do you have any idea?
Sir, actually, the degreening is main. No, sir. Yes, sir, continue, sir. Later I will explain.
Degreening, I think, to give it the fruit good color. Because after harvesting the color, maybe I think it may not develop well. But I think, means I am not sure, but because of due to give good color to the fruit, they do. Because it face more price. If anyone want to correct, they can.
Impa.
Sir, the degreening is mainly to attract the consumers. Like if it is green, they will think that if it is like they will come to know that it will be not very sweet in taste. Like we will also think like in mango, it will be they will put some chemical and it leads to the ripening. So what they'll do is they'll do the degreening, and what happens by that the intensity of that green color decreases. By that we will think that it is ripe and it is very sweet in taste.
Because I think there is no relationship between this climatic, non-climatic and degreening, right?
So there was a question that degreening is generally performed in climatic, non-climatic fruit, I guess.
Citrus, I think it is non-climatic or climatic.
Citrus is non-climatic, sir.
That's why I'm telling you. In non-climatic, case of non-climatic, fruit not mature after harvesting. Means the ripening is not there. I think so.
We'll ask any fruit science student and I will clarify, don't worry about it.
Generally, but the main motive of degreening is to get good color.
I can add to that one.
Yes, please, sir.
Yeah.
Actually, in citrus, degreening is generally done for uniform ripening. Actually, in some climatic conditions, there will be not uniform ripening of every fruits. Okay, after that one, for export purpose, not for only export purpose, for marketing purpose, if any citrus fruits, if it is appearing like green color, like if you see in mandarin or orange, if it is in green color, no one will accept that one. So for consumer acceptance, degreening is generally processed by application of ethylene. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, Deepak. Thank you so much.
Okay.
I think if you have any questions, you can put over here in question and answer section. Now it's time for